At ChemCon the Americas 2018 in New Orleans, we discussed the developments and goals for Latin America's chemicals legislation. The main conclusion in 2018, there is no regulatory consistency in the region, and mañana is soon enough. But there were already signals that authorities would put their best foot forward. So let's take a look at today's state of play with Alejandra Acosta from the Ministry of Environment and Sustainable Development of Argentina and Roland Bierger from Sherwin-Williams. Welcome. Alejandra, in 2018, Brazil was the front runner in Latin America. Are they still leading the dance?
I can say that during 2018 and 2019, maybe it was particularly Argentina who took the front row in leading chemical regulation, and several other countries, particularly those that were planning to enter OECD, started doing their business as well. But I can say that I expect Brazil to come back again. They got the support from USA to enter OECD.
Okay, and what kind of initiative do you see then?
Well, definitely we're talking mainly about risk management activities, inventories, DHS. They have, as we all in the region, we still have a lot of things to implement when it comes to DHS.
And which countries did actually implement new legislation in the last 2 years?
Argentina did have some legislation coming forward, but we can say as well that since Mexico, Peru, Colombia, and Chile, they are in the running to become or are already part of OECD, so they do have a lot of draft legislation in place. And Argentina as well, there is a bill in Congress for risk management and inventories, so we expect to have that approved by maybe the end of this year or next year.
Roland, the Latin American Regulatory Cooperation Forum, they encourage local authorities to establish regulatory cooperation between the different countries. Would you also define the current developments, as Alejandra described, as a success?
From where we started with individual countries doing individual legislations, I think we have seen more collaboration. Clearly, from an industry standpoint, we would want this to increase further, and I think the forum from industry side is trying to encourage risk-based legislations, cooperation between the governments to have frameworks in place that serve the objective.
Alejandra, can we already identify shared best practices and directions for developing chemicals regulations in Latin America?
There are several initiatives that we can copy and we can use. I do believe that in the region, nobody wants to invent the wheel again. So we are looking to other economies that have already experience in all these matters. So for example, the US-Mexico-Canada agreement is an agreement that we are looking, we are studying, and also with the industry forum.
One of the countries in the region is Mexico. They seem to start moving forward, Roland. Are there developments in line with defined principles on regulatory cooperation in the region?
So this is very recent, and I think looking at the timeline, looking at the checkpoints, there are various checkpoints with industry. There are various parts where industry can collaborate, so that's a positive point. I would say a regulatory impact analysis should really, a thorough impact analysis should really make part of this proposal to understand all the impacts and what this means for Mexican economy, for Mexican environment and health.
In 2018, we also looked into the global harmonized system and the fact that various regions would use DHS building blocks. And you even mentioned that some countries were considering to use the European COP blocks. What is the current status on this?
In Latin America, most countries use UN GHS building blocks and essentially the full set, with exception from Mexico, where we don't use the environmental hazards. There was one development last year where Brazil changed not their building blocks, but the mixture cutoff rules. Wherever the UNGHS has two possible options, Brazil moved from the conservative one to the less conservative one, which aligns the Brazilian mixture rules essentially with CLP. I think the big exception, and we talked about this 2 years ago, is Chile. Their GHS draft includes a CLP-like GHS in terms of building blocks, in terms of mixture cutoffs, and also in terms of a harmonized classification list which should be similar to or initially based on Annex 6 of CLP.
Talking about harmonization, the forum that you represent a focus on harmonizing developments in the region. Can you describe some developments initiated by the forum recently?
And it was a very Brazil-focused initiative initially, but over these 2 years it has grown considerably. So there are chemical associations and stakeholders participating from many countries in the region. Countries represented from Latin America, but clearly the major economies are making part.
Building trust between industry and government in Latin American countries is the most efficient way to actually implement regulatory frameworks on sound management of chemicals. Alejandra, what is the strategy of authorities in the region to achieve those stakeholder engagements and alignment?
I definitely agree. I mean, trust is one of the main issues, but also for us, it's having long-term policies. So in that sense, having a strong communication channels between the industry and the government is needed. Having the industry backupping the legislation and the activities that the government has to put in place is also something needed. And I would say also there is the SICOM Beyond 2020 process that's having a huge impact in the region as well. There we are discussing how to make this collaboration among all stakeholders stronger and sustainable a long time. And finally, I can say within the region we have the Intergovernmental Network. It's a network of that manages chemicals and waste that was put forward by the Forum of Ministries of Environment of the region. And there is a plan for implementing chemicals and waste management along the region. So
Roland, is there a specific strategy for the forum to engage that kind of stakeholder engagement?
Well, I mean, the forum is meant to represent one voice for industry, similar to what Alejandra mentions about the cooperation between the governments. And we have, during the workshop in Argentina, we had some outcomes. One was the establishment of virtual working groups on GHS and chemical management. Another one is a position paper that we suggest to put forward, which defines the importance of chemical cooperation. Another one, if I can continue, is capacity building. I think from both sides, we still have a lot to learn.
Thank you very much for your input. Great to see authority and industry working together, because we all know it takes two to tango.